Hello friends, my dear students, in previous session we have discussed about sum operators. You must have seen we have discussed about Python operators. So under the Python basics, in any language we have to learn some basics, and operators are one of the components that is essential to perform certain operations. So arithmetic operator we have discussed in last session. Now today we will discuss about Python operators, in which we will cover relational operator. Okay, so now what is relational operator? Anybody tell me what is arithmetic operator which we have discussed as earlier? Yes, arithmetic operators are those operators which perform basic mathematical operations, basic arithmetical operations like addition, like division, multiplication and subtraction, modulus operator, anymore? Yes, floor division operator. So these are some operators which we have discussed in arithmetic operator. Now we are talking about relational operator. As the name suggests, relational means these operators relate between two values. Okay, it establishes a relationship between values, or you may call it operands. Of course, operands are those values or the variables or the constant on which operator performs certain operations. You have discussed earlier. Suppose we have written x plus y. So x and y are operands here, and plus is a arithmetic operator. So, but now we are talking about the relational operator. So relational operators are used to describe relationship between values and or operands. In Python you have six relational operator for comparing values. Keep in mind, it is basically used to compare values. For example, here first of all we will learn what are these operators. These six operators are greater than. You must have heard about greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, double equal to and not equal to. Maybe you have not heard about double equal to. Equal to you have heard in class 6 or earlier. Yes. In mathematics also we use equal to, science also we use equal to. So equal to is used at many places, but double equal to is something different, or not equal to is something different. So I will tell you. Okay, suppose we have two variables. One is a is equal to 9 and b is equal to 5. It may be any value, not exactly 9 and 5 every time, because these are variables. So the value of a and b can be varied according to your choice. You may take a is equal to 5 and b is equal to 9, or you may take a is equal to 2 or b is equal to 3. Any value, whatever you like, that value can be considered while whatever value you can consider, that can be taken. Okay, so now we are putting a is greater than b. Suppose I am writing A is greater than B. Now greater than symbol is placed here. It's a relation. It is creating a relation between these two values A and B. It is comparing whether A is greater than B. Now put the values of A and B which is given earlier in the header. Now if you put 9 in place of A and 5 in place of B, what will you get? 9 is greater than 5. Now tell me yes or no result. Yes, 9 is greater than 5. Yes. So yes can be taken as true and no can be taken as false. In computer everything is in the form of true and false. So your yes will be designated to true and your false will be pointing out to, your no will be pointing out to false. Okay. In the same way, if we go into the next line, we can see A is less than B. Now here, what happens? The value of A is 9 and the value of B is 5. 9 is less than 5. Yes or no? No, yes. So it's no. The resultant of this value will be no. No means false. So in this way, you can see whether you will get true value or you will get false value. So we can conclude. What we can conclude? We can conclude that resultant of the comparison operator will be either true or false. Either it will be true or it will be false. So I have written here. You can see here resultant of the comparison operator will be either true or false. Now the next, A is greater than B. Suppose I have given A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 5. Now the question raises, A is greater than 5? No. A is equal to 5? Yes. So A is equal to 5. So this condition becomes true. So that's why it's a true. Yes. In the same case, if I write this, A is less than equal to 5. Suppose A is also 5, B is also 5. 5 is less than equal to 5. Yes. 5 is less than equal to 5. In this case, it will be yes. Equal to hora. So it will give true result. But in our case, in the above values, according to these values, A is 9, B is 5, 9 is less than 5, no, 9 is equal to 5, no, so the result, overall result is no. Okay, so here two conditions are given as a single operator, okay, less than equal to. Now A double equal to B, it will compare two values. Suppose you write A is equal to B, what does it mean? It means the value of A is assigned to B. Suppose the value of A is 9. Okay. The value of A is 9. And the value of B is 3. So if we write A is equal to, let me give you practical demonstration of this. Okay. Suppose A is equal to 9. Now here what happens? When I put equal to, so the value of A is 9. If I print A, what will you get? 9. If I write B is equal to 8, okay. Now I have taken another variable, that is B, and assigned the value is 8. So B is equal to 8. Now the value of B will be, what will be the value of B? 8. Of course. Now if I do what? A double equal to B, what will you get? It is doing what? It is comparing the value of A with the value of B. So you will definitely get false, because 9 is equal to 8. No. It's not equal to 8. So that's why it is returning false. If I write A is equal to B, what will happen? What will happen? The value of A will change and it become 8. Print A. What happened? Earlier you can see the value of A was 9, but now it became the value of A became 8. Why does it happen? Because you have assigned B into A. The B has been assigned to A. So when you have given equal symbol alone, then it is work as assignment operator and assign the value to the left hand side variable. Okay, and when you give double equal to, it will compare these two values, and depending on the values, it will either return true or return false. I think it is understood now. Everybody understood it? Okay, now what? Another one is, you can see in our diagram, our slide, that not equal to. One more is not equal to. Not equal to, what does it do? It checks whether the two values are not equal to each other. Suppose A is not equal to B. Is it okay? What will you get? True or false? True or false? You will get false. Why so? Because the value of A was what? You have changed the value of A here. You have made the value of A is, dekho, let's see here. The value of A is 8 and the value of B is also 8. So A is not equal to 8 is not equal to 8. False. Okay. Actually, what happens? It is serial processing. Serial means the one after another. So earlier the value of A was 9, but in the future course of action, you have seen what? In the further course of action, you have seen you have changed the value of A by assigning B to A. So the value became 8. So the value of A is also 8 and B is also 8. So that's why not equal to is returning false. Is it okay? Yes. Now we will do the exercise. The values that operator operates on are called operands, of course. 9% 3 evaluate to what will percent operator perform operation? What operation will be performed by percent? Yes, it's a modulus operator. Yes. So 9% 3. Any remainder it will return? No. So it will return only 0. So 9% 3 will evaluate to 0. Other one is dash is the combination of operator and operands. What? Expression is the combination of operator and operand. Dash operators are also known as comparison operator. Just now we have read about it. Relational operator are also known as comparison operator. What will be the result of the expression 17 pure division 4? So you will get 4 only. Okay. So in this floor division operator, you will get quotient part. So you will get 4, no remainder. Okay. Rest of the exercise you have to do at your own. Okay. Take care. Bye.